my past. Your love is an ocean, trading my beauty for ashes. Beauty for ashes. God of mercy, God of mercy, always with me, always with me. God of mercy, God of mercy, you're always with me, always with me.
Oh, full of mercy,
you're full of mercy,
full of mercy.
Oh, you're always with me.
God, God of mercy,
full of mercy. Yes, you're always.
Of the matter is that there is none like you, and because of that we give you honor and we give your name praise this morning. Hallelujah, we thank you this morning. God, you counted not robbery, but you woke us up this morning. God, you started us on our way. God, we got blood running warm in our veins. We've got the activity of our limbs. God, we got clothes on our backs. God, you put us in a car and got us here safely this morning. So we take this moment to give you praise and to give you glory and to honor who you are, God. You didn't have to do it, but you loved us so much and you did it anyway. And we owe you praise this morning. We owe you worship this morning. God, we owe you every thank you, Jesus, and every hallelujah that we can muster up. We owe you that this morning. For you're deserving of all our praise and all of our worship. So we tell you thank you this morning. Come on, saints, tell them thank you this morning. Hallelujah. We have a thank you praise in our bellies this morning. Hallelujah. We just want your will to be done on earth as it is in heaven, God. And we pray now that you would have your way in this place. God, move by your power and by your spirit this morning. Hey, move by your power and by your spirit this morning. We want your glory to fill this house this morning. We can't do nothing without your glory, God. We can't do nothing without your presence, oh God. So we invite you to come in the room right now. We invite you to come in the room right now and inhabit right here. Make your dwelling place right here, for you inhabit the praises of your people. So we make an atmosphere conducive for you to move how you want to move and do what you want to do in this place. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus, send that anointing now. In the name of Jesus that can destroy every yoke. God, anoint our co-pastor now as she brings forth the word of God on this morning. Anoint her afresh in the mighty name of Jesus and strengthen her body now. Touch our bishop on this morning. Strengthen his body even now as we pray. God, anoint your people that have come together to worship you together today. God, I pray for a special anointing to rest on each and every one of us that's here on today. Those that are watching us live, I dare you to go right through the airwaves and touch them right where they are this morning. Somebody needs a healing. Somebody needs deliverance. Somebody's in need of a breakthrough on today, God. So can you go right where you are? Go right where they are and stretch forth your hands and touch them now in the name of Jesus. God, touch those who need to be healed today, that need to be delivered on today, God. This is the atmosphere that miracles will take place. We speak it and we declare it now that this is the atmosphere that breakthrough shall take place in the mighty name of Jesus. So our prayer today is have your way, Holy Ghost. Have your way, Holy Ghost. Have your way, Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and we do believe. Come on, saints, put those hands together right here and give them glory. Come on. That's it. Don't stop, but clap those hands, all ye people. Shout to God with a voice of triumph. Come on, that's what we come to do. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let's exalt his name together. Together is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's go forth in praise and worship.
Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Come on, can you please keep a praise on your lips right where you are? Can you keep some worship on your lips right where you are? You're a mighty God. You're a mighty God. And we worship you, Jesus. You're a mighty God. You're a mighty God. And we give you praise. You're a mighty God. And you're a mighty God. And we reverence your name. Come on in the room, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I was reading the comments while I was waiting to come up, and it said, come on in the room, Jesus. So we're going to say, come on in the room, Jesus. Come on in the room, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're expecting an unusual move from you today. Come on in the room, Jesus, and do what you do, God. Come on in the room, Jesus. Hallelujah. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way, Jesus. Have your way. Have your way. Come on, behind your mask, keep your praise going. Come on, Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. We magnify you, God. You're strong and you're mighty. You're strong and you're mighty, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, can you sing a new song to him? Oh, we love you, we love you. We love you, we love you, Jesus. Wonderful is your name, oh God. Wonderful is your name. Come on, right where you are, make a new song to him. We love you, we love you, we love you. Come on, we love you, we love you, we love you. I know you're waiting for a song, but can we worship him for a minute? We love you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. my living room. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Oh, yeah. Yeah. We glorify your name, Jesus. We glorify your name, Jesus. We glorify your name, Jesus. We make you big in this place, oh God. Bigger than our issues. Bigger than our problems. Bigger than our circumstances. We make your name great this morning, God. We set an atmosphere for you to move, Jesus. We set an atmosphere for you to move, Jesus. Hey, hey. Oh, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Good morning, Truth Tabernacle. Good morning, Truth Tabernacle. It feels good in here. Good morning, Truth Tabernacle. Hey, wonderful Savior. Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus.
Lord, you're mighty.
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 Oh, Lord, you're mighty.
You're so mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Yeah. Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
What a mighty God we serve. Sing it with me. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before a mighty God. You are so mighty. Creator, the sun, the moon, and the stars. No praise is high enough.
No praise is high enough
to express
how great you are.
So what a mighty God we serve.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, say, all glory. We give you glory.
We
yes, Lord.
We give you the praise.
We take the honor.
You take the honor, Lord.
You get the honor, Lord.
Oh, glory.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And honor.
And honor.
Oh, praise.
Oh, praise.
Oh, praise. What a mighty God we serve.
Yeah.
What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before you.
Yes, Lord.
So we join with heaven and adore you. Yes, Lord. What a mighty God we serve. Come on, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before you. Heaven and earth adore him. You need from God. What a mighty God.
Yes, she had
a monster for the Bessiana. Yes, she had a monster. What a mighty God, what a mighty God! Yes, Sunday at the so for the Amanda Saya. Yanana Mansiaya. Oh, Shianaya Mansia de Mansaya. Get what you need, he's here.
In the sanctuary, right where you are, as our minstrels continue to keep us in that flow, I want you to lift your hands and open your mouth. I know we have our mask on and that's appropriate, but I want you to, right in your space, to lift up a praise of worship to the God who is mighty in your life. You couldn't even stand here without him being mighty in your life. Hallelujah. As our minstrels keep us right here in this flow, right here, I want you to just worship the Lord for the next 30 seconds once again. Come on. We're not letting go of it. We're not letting go of it just yet. Hallelujah. There's something that's in the atmosphere that the Lord wants to do. He wants to say something to you. So now you have to focus your mind and focus all of who you are on what he wants to do. And those of you who are watching us online, I want you to stop whatever you're doing right now, because there is a move, there is a wave. Oh, Bashanda Sokora. He shekeron na masaya. There is a move and a wave of the power of the Holy Ghost right here and right now. The angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adores him. We know those are the words to the song, but I just want you to take a moment and in your own way bow before him. Whatever that looks like, in your own way, bow before him. Aya, yes, Lord. In your own way, bow before him. Because he's King of Kings. He's Lord of Lords. He is El Shaddai, the Elohim. He is more than enough. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah to Jesus. Oh, yes, we bow before you, Lord. Oh, yes, we bow before you, oh God. We bow in your presence, Lord. And we said, do whatever you want to do with us today. God, here we are. We stand, God. We bow on our knees. We lay prostrate before you, even in the living room, even in the bedroom, even in the sitting room, even in the family room, wherever you are, in your car, pulled along the side of the road. Take these moments right here and just worship your King and just worship your God. If it had not been for him, where would we be? If it had not been for, I believe God is setting us up for something. Woo, Yesha, Namahaya, Woo, Kerabosia, Namashe. As we worship him, as we worship him, as we call on his great name. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Have your way, Holy Spirit. Do what you've come to do in the name of Jesus. And we give you all of the glory. And we give you all of the praise. We worship you, our Lord. We worship you, our Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's a good day to be alive in his presence. And it's tough to move when there is such a move. When there's such a move of God's grace and power. Come on and lift your hands to Jesus. Come on and lift your hands to Jesus. Woo! Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. The presence of the Lord is here. I know he's in your house right now. I know he's present with you wherever you are right now. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Woo! Glory, glory, glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We thank you and we worship you. We thank you and we worship you. For you're Christ the Lord. You're the King. You're the great I am. You're more than enough. And we give you all the glory and all the praise. Hallelujah. Will you clap your hands and give the Lord just a great praise in your own way? In your own way, in your own way. We give you all the glory. We worship you. We worship you. worship. Father, we give you all of the glory and we give you all of the praise, for you are certainly worthy of it all. We greet you this morning. Thank you for joining us here at Truth Tabernacle Online. We greet you this morning with Jesus' joy, and at his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. The Lord is good. I said the Lord is good. We celebrate our worship team on this morning for ushering us into the presence of the Lord. Amen. We thank you so much, worship team, and to everyone in your respective places. We honor Bishop on this morning. Amen. And celebrate him on this morning, this Lord's Day. It's so good to be alive. I said, it's so good to be alive. I don't take it for granted that I am still 6 feet above ground. I don't take it for granted. Every time I wake up, I'm just so grateful to be alive and to be breathing. To you who are sharing with us online, we ask that you go ahead and get a watch party going. Amen. I believe the Lord is going to say something to us today. For those of you, to my Truth family, to all of you, we just love you today. From wherever you are coming in from, thank you for joining us here at Truth Tabernacle. We are in the sanctuary. We are social distancing. Amen. We are coming with our mask on, but we are in the presence of the Lord. And I know you can be in his presence anywhere, but it's something about being collectively in his presence of the Lord where we pull on each other's strength. And I'm just so grateful for that. I want us to continue to pray for our mother who has gone on to be with the Lord, to pray for that family, Sister Iris Parker, Mother Adele Keith, who has transitioned and gone on to be with the Lord. And we are so grateful that God allowed her the years to be with us and under Bishop's leadership and be a sainted mother here at Truth Tabernacle Ministries. So let's keep that family lifted up in prayer. Another very important announcement. This is a very, 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 very important announcement for those of you that are in the sanctuary, as well as those of you who have joined us online. It is very critical that you vote. Your voice is what changes things. Not the violence, not the looting, not the rioting, but your vote is what changes things. When you get out and vote, when whatever means, however you can vote, if it's mailing in your ballot, if it's going to the polls. I'm watching on television so many people that are speaking in this time, because this is a critical time. Our nation is in crises and we need to go out and vote. Please make no excuse. If you haven't registered, register and vote. Please make no excuse. There are too many vehicles that we have in front of us. As a black group, as a black Americans, we are proud of our ethnicity and we stand tall. And I'm asking you to please go out and vote. God bless you. Now that we've done our civil duty unto you on this morning, I'm grateful for how God has been using our bishop in this word and the teachings that we've been hearing on Wednesday night and the preaching on Sunday mornings. And I'm just so grateful to be before you on this morning. I want to go into the word of the Lord, Romans chapter number 8. Romans chapter number 8. Please get it on your devices. Get your Bibles in your hand. Let's stand for the reading of God's word. It's a very familiar passage of scripture, but I believe the Lord has something he wants to say out of this familiar epistle, a letter that Paul has written to the church at Rome. He's in Corinth. He's in prison, but he's writing to the church at Rome. He's writing to the saints. So here we have Romans 8, chapter 8, verses 26 through verse 30. I'm going to be reading from the NIV translation of the Bible. When you have it, say, I have the word. I want you to be excited. I want you to say it again. I have the word. Romans 8, 26 through verse 30. In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. And he who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. This is the word of the Lord. Somebody ought to shout, thanks be unto God. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. For those God foreknew, he had also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son. I want to talk for just these few moments that I have. The bridge that brings me into destiny. I got these few minutes, and so let me just, I just want you to signify that you're on a bridge. And I just want you to just say this with me, the bridge that brings me into destiny. I'm going somewhere. I'm on my way. I haven't quite arrived, but I'm on the bridge. Y'all sit down for just a moment. Sit down for just a moment. Go ahead, those of you that are online with us this morning, and type that in, the bridge that brings me into destiny. I'm on the bridge. I'm on it. I'm on the bridge. Everyone listening and watching today, please believe that you have destiny. Given the climate of our nation and the uncertainty of this pandemic, it could keep us bound in time and bound by circumstances. I need to say that again. With the climate of our nation and the uncertainty of this pandemic, if we're not careful, it would keep us bound in time and bound by circumstances. It is important that you understand, and while I will follow the science, because I believe in the science, I will follow the science, and while the science and all of this that we are experiencing is being politicized, we have to be careful that we don't lend our ear to the politics of the pandemic, but we lend our ear to the God who's over the politics and who's over the pandemic. I just said something good right there. There is a destiny that is beyond your plans. There is a we can make our plans, because in our lives we have a rhythm that is either taught to us as we are children growing up, or we identify with it as we are exposed to life's experiences to find that rhythm, what that rhythm is. How do I get from point A to point B and from point B to point C? It is essential that you find, that you discover, or identify the bridge that's structured through some unorthodox means with disruptions that occur in your set rhythm. I know that was a mouthful. In other words, there are some bridges that are not as stable as others. There are some bridges that the foundations have cracked, And so it takes the architecture, it takes the architect to go down to the seabeds of bridges that cover bodies of waters and bridges that are connecting one city to the next, or the state to the next, or the inland to the mainland. And it is important that when they go down to check that how the bridge was structured, that it can stand the storms of time, and it can weather whatever happens as the earth continues to shift. Lord, help me to get this in, Lord, because the earth has constantly been shifting. It shifts its weight from one spectrum to the other spectrum. And so the foundation, the structure of the bridge has to be examined and re-examined on at different times and different seasons. There are some unorthodox means that I believe God is using some unorthodox means in the midst of this pandemic that will carry us and help us to identify where we are on the bridge we are standing on. I believe that there are some disruptions that have occurred. And by the way, what do you do when there is a disruption in your rhythm? What happens to our soul? What happens to our spirit when there is a disruption in a set rhythm? Because the way I started out, where I am now on the bridge, doesn't look like what I saw at the end. Because where I am, I have to understand that God has already predestined where I'm supposed to be and how I'm going to get there. And while I'm looking at my plans and how I'm going to get to where I believe I'm supposed to go, God can take my plans and turn them inside out, upside down. As a matter of fact, you ought to write my plans on a piece of paper. And before the message is over, I want you to rip it up, because what you have planned in the midst of a pandemic, in the midst of what we call life, sometimes God will use the disruption to usher you right into your destiny. There's a destiny that's beyond our plans, that's attached to the full manifestation of God's purpose for your life. It ain't even about you. That's the first thing we got to realize, that what's happening, this really isn't about me. I can cry, I can lament, I can be depressed, I can be upset, I can pull my hair out, I can have a temper tantrum, but when all of that is said and done, I still got the face, God, how you gonna get us through this? When I'm finished with all of that, it ain't even about you. It's about something greater than yourself. The definition of a bridge is a structure carrying a pathway or a roadway over a depression or obstacle, such as a river. It is a time. The definition of a bridge is it's a time, it's a place or means of connection or transition. And while we are in the transition, God is connecting and reconnecting us to his divine purpose on our lives. The book of Romans is one of the most profound books in existence. It is certainly one of the most valued parts of Holy Scripture. It has been appropriately termed the cathedral of Christian faith. Paul is not writing to a weak, struggling church. He's not writing to an unorganized church. He's writing to the church that seems to be well organized and grounded as a congregation. This subsection of Romans 8:18 through 30 seems to subscribe to the believing saints concerning their predestination and their destiny through some form of suffering. Now, I want to pause right here because the church, don't throw me out of the synagogue, but the church taught us that suffering is the way. That if you ain't suffering something, it means that you're not walking close enough with God, because you ought to be suffering something. And the young people helped me to even get a better understanding that what our mothers and fathers suffered is different from what this generation count as suffering. So they gave me a better understanding and a better clarity that their suffering is different even from my suffering. Their suffering is different from our forefathers and our grandmamas and the mothers of the church and what they had to endure in order to stand fast in critical times. Their suffering in this generation consists of systemic racism. It affects all of us. But for young black men as Elder Travis and Elder Brandon and some of the other young black men, they have to be careful how they even pull over when they are stopped by a policeman. So their whole psychological means is under some form of suffering, because I gotta think ahead before I even get pulled over because of the color of my skin. Their suffering is connected to the pressure that gets put on them by society and the church. That if you don't do it the way I did it, then you ain't suffering for it. You ain't paying a price. You don't love God like I love God. But the truth of the matter is, they do love God, but their suffering doesn't look like our suffering. So there is a form of suffering that all of us go through in life at different eras of life that doesn't look the same, but it does feel the same. It has pain with it. It has confusing thoughts with it. It has some days when I don't know whether to trust God. And it has some days when I'm giving God all I can give him, and it still doesn't feel like I'm getting ahead. It still doesn't feel like the manifestation of God's destiny, God's divine hand is on my life. I'm succeeding in my career. I got enough money in the bank, but my spirit is still longing for something that I haven't tapped into yet. Lord, I feel like preaching. My family is well, and my marriage is going good, and my babies aren't sick, but my spirit is longing for a place in God that creates the definition of my destiny. Lord, help me right here. My spirit, I pray, I read the word, I worship before the Lord in my personal private time, but somehow or another, there's something that's on the bridge I'm on that's blocking me. There's some traffic that's backing me up that I can't see what's happening. I don't know if there are any red and blue lights up ahead of me, but something got me backed up on the bridge and I can't see, but I know I got a destiny. Lord, help me to get to where I'm trying to go. God understands that, and he sees. And what you got to do as believers, you can't get weary while you're trying to get to your destiny. Lord, have mercy. Sometimes we will get weary, but your weariness can't stop you from moving ahead. You gotta tell every weary moment, come on, we got to cross the bridge. You got to tell every frustrated moment, come on, we got to cross the bridge. You got to tell every circumstance, yep, you are a part of the reason why I'm on the bridge. You, my mommy, Oshania. You got to tell your own mind, shut up, because I got a place that I'm on my way to. Somebody say, I'm on the bridge. I'm on the bridge. I'm on the bridge. So it seems in me, Oshande. Oh, glory to God. In the text, we hear Paul. Paul starts, this section is about the sufferings. This is section, not only is it about the sufferings, but it's also about the glory. Lord have mercy. Yes. And we're not talking about the doctrine per se, a predestination that has engrafted us into the plan of salvation, even though that is a part of the text, but also predestination according to Father Augustine. Father Augustine, in his doctrinal teaching, he says in everything that God does, he's the creator, he's the loving God, he's the God that makes it, he's the God that plans it, he's the God that does it. And Augustine says everything that God has made, has planned, he's done it. You ought to just throw up your hands and say, that includes my destiny. Which means my destiny is already secure. Lord have mercy. And it doesn't matter what happens right through in here. I just got to get in touch with what's on the bridge. And so he says, Paul is talking. And he says, he starts out in verse 18, the sufferings of the present times. I don't know if y'all really understand it, but these are some suffering times. You know, suffering sounds so negative, but when I really started to study it, Miss Pat, suffering sounds so, you know, well, just give up and die. No, suffering just simply suggests there's been a loss, you're grieving something, that there's a hardship. It could even suggest there's some sickness. It could suggest that there's some chaos. But in the midst of the sufferings, God has built a fence around his very elect. Lord, help me to preach this. Yes, Lord. So he says, the sufferings of the present times. Listen, let me tell you what was happening right here in the text during the time. Nero was the one in charge. And because Nero was in charge, Nero was a king that was cruel. He was a cruel king. He was a king that was full of vanity and loved power. I ain't saying nothing about nobody. They were under a Neronian leadership. A Neronian leadership. And the Neronian leadership, Shanna, would suppress all of those who had converted from Judaism into Christianity. So now the Jews have taken on the understanding of the crucifixion of Jesus at the cross, because Paul had been preaching. That's why he's in jail, because they are under this Roman government that continues to try to suppress Christianity. Sounds like something going on to me in our world. There is so much suppression that it starts to mess with our minds. So much suppression that wants to keep us beneath and not have any privileges. But see, while they have a king, there's somebody that's lord over the king. Lord have mercy. And because they were suffering, even though the church was a good church, it was a community church, it was a community of mixed breeds, because now everybody got all things in common. Everybody wants to do what is right for everybody else. And so under this Neronian leadership, he's trying to overthrow Christianity, because these are people who were pagans and they worship polytheistic gods and goddesses, the sun god, the moon god, the rain god, the fertility god. If it was existing, they made it a god. Lord have mercy. And because he wanted to keep all of those things under his rule. But when God has marked your life, and when God has called and predestined in order for your life, can't no demon, no spirit, no witches, no hexes, no spells, no witchcraft, no warfare can hold back the promise of your destiny that's on your life. He said, the sufferings of the present time, God is so God that he can create and allow problems, turmoil, and trouble that leads you to your destiny. And he continues to talk about the sufferings of the present time. He says, the whole earth is groaning and in travail even right now. That's in the text. Paul was saying something even for our latter day times. The whole earth, I don't know if you can see it or sense it, but there's a lot of travailing going on, even in our plant life, even in the firmaments. There's a whole lot of climate change that is happening in our world. People are scared. There's fear. There's confusion. The whole earth is groaning within itself for the expectation, waiting for the revelation of the sons of God. That's where you and I come into destiny. The whole creation is groaning and labors in birth pains even together now. But when we hope, we gotta hope for what we don't see, for what we see is not hope. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. If I see it, that ain't enough hope. You see, I got to have faith enough to believe that even while I'm on this bridge that's leading me to my destiny, I can't let the winds that shake the bridge, that rocks me on the bridge, I can't let the storms, I can't let the circumstances get in the way of my destiny. I have to embrace the circumstance and make the circumstance work for my good. I just need about 10 people in here to just throw up your hands and open up your mouth and say, I'm going to make it all work. I'm going to make the good work. I'm going to make the bad work. I'm going to make everything that's on my bridge work towards my destiny. If I got any witnesses online, just go ahead and type, it's going to work on the bridge. It's going to work. It's going to work on the bridge. Now as I get ready to close, Lord Jesus, I got 3 minutes. The Bible says, hope for what we do not see. Eagerly wait for it with perseverance. The first thing I need you to understand, that in spite or despite of the difficulty and despite the delay, God is going to give you strength through the circumstances to allow you to cross the bridge. I just came to tell somebody, I'm ready to go, y'all. I got 2.5 minutes left, but I came to tell somebody that right through in here now, we're close to the election. People have already voted, over 52 million Americans, and yes, we still are in a pandemic, and they are predicting a hard, dark winter, but I want to prophesy to every believer that even if it is so, there is a fountain filled with blood that is drawn from Emmanuel's vein. And when I prayed yesterday here in the church, the Lord said there is a blood covering over the saints of God that I have provided for those that I have predestined, where I have divinely ordered their life and I have divinely ordered their steps. The reason why we are still here is because of God's blood covering us and God's blood prevailing over our lives. I want you to know that you got to persevere despite your difficulties. I want you to know you got to persevere despite the delay, inclusive of myself. I thought I would be further than I am, but the delay doesn't mean I'm denied, and the delay doesn't mean I won't get there. I just got to discern what's on the bridge that's gonna take me to the main line. Somebody shout yes. Come on and shout yes. The Bible says that the Spirit helps our weakness. I don't know about you, but sometimes the circumstances will cause me to get weak. I'm not talking about weak to sin, but weak in my mind. And when we were teaching on the other night that our mind would need to be renewed and we would have to have a spiritual mind, what is it that connects us to our God? It's the Spirit of God that when we pray, God understands. The Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord will speak on our behalf, and he will make intercession for us with wordless groans. There are some groans in our spirit that you got to pay attention to. Don't try to interpret, but just know, mother void, that God understands what the groan is, and he's going to use the circumstance to get you across the bridge. I don't know what else we need in order to persevere, but it starts with prayer. Prayer is the foundation of the structure of our bridge. Prayer will stand the test of time. Prayer will hold us together. Prayer will shake heaven and earth. Is there anybody here that knows that prayer still works? Lord have mercy. The current events of our day, prayer is the foundation to the structure of the bridge. The circumstances creates the tension. Lord have mercy. I got some tension. The circumstances, it creates the tension to my destiny. But every now and then, we need a little tension in our lives that will cause us to submit to his will and submit to his way. Every now and then, we need a little tension between us and God that makes us realize we have to relinquish our will. We have to relinquish our ways and pray according to the Spirit. But there is a dimension in prayer. There is a dimension in spiritual realms that aligns us and realigns us to the will of the Father. May I suggest to you that the reason why you can't get there and you see nothing but traffic on the bridge, you don't even know why it's backed up. I remember y'all when, as a little girl, growing up and going to church on the eastern shores of Maryland, there's something called the Chesapeake Bay Bridge. I don't know if you've ever crossed it, but that bridge was the scariest bridge. Even today it's still scary, and they rebuilt the bridge and they restructured the bridge. What made the bridge so scary? It was a two-lane bridge. You couldn't go to the right, you couldn't move to the left, otherwise it was going to be a collision. And the only thing you had on the right and left was a great body of water. And I thought, as a girl, you had to be an Olympic swimmer in order to survive any accident that would throw you over. God told me to tell you that even though you're on a scary bridge, he's got the structure. He's holding it together. You don't have to go to the left. You don't have to go to the right. But just keep looking to the hills from whence cometh your help. Just keep looking straight. I read an article that just as recent as last week, they had a 22-year-old boy that was on the Bay Bridge, and he was doing donuts and he was doing spins on the bridge, and it caused a major accident, and it backed up traffic for 6.5 miles. Now the bridge itself is 4.5 miles long and about 300 to 2,000 feet in the air. And when you're that high up and all you see is water, you will pump the brakes. But the Lord told me to tell you, don't pump the brakes in this season that I have you on. You've already bypassed the accident. You've already traffic. Just keep looking to the author and finisher of our faith. Somebody shout yeah. Come on and shout yeah. After we persevere and after we go into dimensions of prayer, what does prayer do, Cole? Let me tell you what prayer does. Prayer will give you the power that will sustain you just in case another windstorm comes. Prayer will give you the power. It is the essential element that comes out of a prayer life, which sustains the bridge during the turmoil, during the trouble, during the turbulence. Prayer will give you power over your tongue. Prayer will give you power over your thoughts. Prayer will give you power over your mind. Some got feeble minds. Our thoughts are wandering. We have imaginations that are not of God. But prayer will give you the power over your mind, that your mind is no longer weak, because the Spirit, I'm in verse 27, will intercede for me. Put your hand on yourself and say, Holy Spirit, I don't know what else to say. I need you to talk for me now. Somebody say, what does the Holy Spirit do? It puts me in the very presence of a holy God. I can persevere. I can pray. But the Spirit puts me in the presence where the Spirit makes known what I can't conceive. The Spirit makes known what I can't comprehend. The Spirit makes known the fullness of my joy. Where did you get that from? Acts 2 and 28 says, you have made me to know. You made me known. Yes, Lord, the ways of life. In other words, God has been with me through every experience. But in the latter clause, he says, you will make me full of joy in your presence. While I have been made to know what life experiences are, but in his presence, there's the fullness of joy. I got joy on my bridge, even though I'm in pain. I got joy on the bridge when I don't know the answers to the questions. I got joy, the fullness of joy. It's a joy that the world can't give. It's a joy that makes me happy when I should be crying. It's a joy that floods the spirit of my mind. Yes! Yes! I'm closing. And we know. I'm skipping through here. And we know that in all things, God works. As you stand to your feet, I said, in all things, God works. I'm closing. Second time. In all things, God works. Lord, have mercy. I just kept hearing it. In all things, God works. How does God work in a pandemic? We're still here. I know we've lost some lives. Over 230,000. But for those of us who are still here and yet remains, I know that my destiny is attached to the bridge I'm on. And the bridge I'm on is attached to my destiny. In all things, God works. What are you talking about, preacher? Oh, Mark, don't do that. Somebody, whatever, who did that? I felt the praise right there. God is changing the trajectory of your entire life. I like the way the young people say it. He's blessing my whole life. Lord have mercy. In the midst of a pandemic, I'm not starving because God is changing the trajectory of my whole life. God is shifting you for a specific assignment, and this is a part of all things work. God is in the all things. God allowed you to move even though you thought you were moving for another reason, but he had ordered your steps. God allowed for the realtor to give you the loan. God allowed for the bank to give you the money and the realtor to build the house. God allowed for the loan to be approved. Somebody ought to say, God did it, 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 God did it. God allowed everything that you're going through right now. Some of it is good, some of it is bad. He's not working it out just for me. He's not working it out just for you, but he's working it out as a testimony of his power. He's working it out as a testimony of his glory. Paul said, we have been predestined. God foreknew that you were gonna act like a monkey without a banana. God foreknew that you weren't gonna behave well, but he also knew that you were gonna hold fast to the profession of your faith. Hold on, your glory is coming. Your glory is coming. Just put your hand on yourself and say, self, I got two glories. Put your hand on yourself and say, self, the bridge that's bringing me into my destiny. And I don't know what your bridge is, but this bridge, within context of the text, it was a bridge of suffering for the saints. And it might not be a suffering bridge for you. It might be a lack of money bridge for you. It might be a sickness bridge, but whatever, somebody said, whatever, whatever. I know you got mask on, but say it as loud as you can. Say, whatever, whatever. Whatever the bridge is, I'm going into my destiny. I know I see stuff on the left and on the right, but that doesn't concern me. What concerns me is what's ahead of me. And because somebody else is waiting on the anointing that's on my life, Lord, I feel like doing the flip right there. Somebody is waiting for the anointing. Somebody is waiting for the oil that you have. And because the oil is being produced out of this circumstance, there is an oil. I'm not shy. I feel the prophetic. I'm not shaky. There's an oil that's being produced out of this circumstance. There is an oil that's making you ready for what God has already destined for your life. Throw up your hands and say, breathe on me. Anoint me. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. There's an oil that's coming out of the circumstances that's the bridge that he's preparing me. He's preparing you for. Prayer is essential, that we understand that there are dimensions in prayer that helps us in crossing this bridge. There are dimensions, I can't get away from it. Even during my prayer time this week, I just said, Lord, my soul is so thirsty for that dimension in prayer.
It's a place that I long for in you. And just when I think I'm in that place, something else breaks off, Chris. But then I have to be reminded that this is not even a part of the circumstance. Because there's some things that happen that are not a part of the circumstance, but they come as a distraction to the circumstance, so that you get confused about which one is which. Is this the circumstance? Or is this just a distraction so that I don't pay attention to the circumstance and what I'm to get out of the circumstance? Father, we love you today. And we thank you for the bridge that's bringing us into our destiny. We are not going to lament it anymore. We're going to embrace it. We are not going to get in the way. We're not going to let our flesh get in the way. We're not going to let our thoughts get in the way. But we're going to embrace this bridge that we are on. Some, Lord, have been on a bridge of rejection. And they can't seem to get over it. Some, Lord, are just there. And they don't know what to do with their emptiness. I pray that you would fill them with the fullness of your joy. Even those that are online, even those that are listening to me online, I pray, Father, that you would fill them with the fullness of your joy. That we only depend on you and not on any system and not on any person that will get us across the bridge. I thank you, Father, for all that you have done for us until now. Until now. And I thank you for the glory that we've experienced. However we define that glory during this time of pandemic. But I'm grateful for the glory that comes even after. These are just light afflictions. And God, while men are trying to suppress us, and to suppress the minorities, the brown skins, the black skins, the yellow skins, the world is looking on. We need your hand to move in our direction. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Move your hand in our direction. Move your hand in our direction. That we are not burdened. Move your hand in our direction. That we don't live in fear. Move your hand in our direction. That we don't live under the hand of someone who doesn't care. Move your hand in our direction. Not just for the saints, but for our country that is all inclusive of the kingdom. We're not praying selfishly, God, but we're praying that all that includes your kingdom. Move your hand in our direction. Woo! In the name of Jesus, we trust your hand. We depend on your hand. We commit our spirit into your hand. In Jesus' name, and we thank you, and we bless you. Can you clap your hands and give the Lord a praise? Come on and clap your hands. Open your mouth for just a moment. Open your mouth for just a moment. Don't let it go. Don't let it go. I know we're just a little long. Our time escaped us. But don't let it go. Don't let it go. Don't let it go. Come on and clap your hands just once again. Once again. It is time that we give. That song that Bishop, I think he penned it some years ago, Move with the Cloud. Move with the cloud. The cloud is moving. Move with the cloud. I don't know if we know that, musicians. But I feel that the hand of the Lord is going to be moving in our lives, even while we're on this bridge, that we don't understand all of the elements, but we know what the circumstances are. I've tapped into what my circumstances are. And now I must hold on to what God said about the circumstances that takes me to my destiny. You'll see on the screen the different ways of giving. I don't know who that's for, but just receive it. Don't get your circumstances confused with the distractions. We want you to give today. I'm giving a special seed offering today. I'm giving a special seed offering. In fact, I'm changing my envelope today. What I had put in my envelope, I'm changing it. We are close. I don't know if y'all remember this. You see it on the screen. Givelify, tithes, tithers, please. Don't forget, we need your tithes. It is right for you to tithe. It's biblical. But I told you the fourth Sunday in August, when we gave you the oil and told you to anoint yourself for the next 90 days. And we are at that 90-day mark where things are going to shift and change. If they haven't already, from that day to this day, some things have happened in my life. I spoke it in my kitchen and I said it to my executive assistant. And 2 weeks after I said it, the Lord opened it up. I was totally baffled. We are at that, it happened for me before the 90 days. Someone saw me in a service and walked over and said, I don't even know why I brought this amount of money to church with me today, but the Lord told me to give it to you as my first fruit offering during the Feast of Tabernacles. I can't tell y'all how much it was. I want to, but I can't. Because that week I needed a certain amount of money, Elder Gale. And I didn't know. I wasn't gonna ask nobody until I got down to the very hour. I mean, the very hour. God is so faithful. So I'm changing my seed offering from $25 to $100 today. I'm changing mine. You do what you want to do, but I want you to give a $90 seed offering, if you can, if you have it. I want you to give a $90 seed offering today. You that are online, you're so close to your destiny. If you just sow this seed with us today, I believe the Lord's going to bless you real good. Not just in the money. Please don't hear that. But it's in the favor that He gives us. It's in the people that He touch that gets us to the next place or the next thing. Will you sow today? Will you sow today? Thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining us this morning. I'm going to trust that you're going to sow a seed today with us. I'm going to trust that you're going to sow a seed today on this very day. Hallelujah. The cloud, God bless you, of glory is moving.
Oh, I need it. Yeah.